Everyone, welcome to the channel UPSC and PCS preparation. My name is Anjali and I'm going to start a series on inside current affairs. So please subscribe to the channel if you like the video so that whenever a new video is being uploaded, you will get an update notification. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So the first news, like the inside current affairs, is divided into sections. So the first few news is related to Indian culture that mainly deals with the art forms, literature, architecture from the ancient to modern times. So the first news is related to Chalukya dynasty. The news is related to the area that is in Karnataka, that is called the Patada Kalu, where an ancient temple, Huligemana Kola, is found. And the place, the inscription and the evidences are found that this place is belong to the royal burial site of the Chalukya dynasty. Some backgrounds have been given which you can cover by reading the insight by yourself. And I will cover like Patada Kalu, where it is located. So please go and check the map and see the location of the Patada Kalu. So it is basically located in the Karnataka near the Mahaprabha river, and which is the tributary of the Krishna. So Patada Kalu is a Visara style of Visara temple, has a Visara temple architecture. And the temple architecture, you already have known that there are mainly three temple architecture: Visara, Nagara, and Dravidian. Nagara is basically in the northern India, Dravidian is basically in the southern India, and the Visara is mainly oriented in the central India. So the Visara is both the combination of the Nagara and the Dravidian. So this is all about the first news. Second news is related to Skand Gupta. So our Union Home Minister Amit Shah recently inaugurated an international seminar on the role of the Gupta dynasty that play a very courageous role in Indian history. So basically, the Skand Gupta is one of the greatest emperor of the Gupta period, who defended against the invading Huns. So this news is related to the Skand Gupta, and he's also known as the savior of the India, has already told that he fought the battle against the invading Huns. And the third news is about the Guru Ravidas. So this news is related regarding the Supreme Court judgment that there should be the demolition of the Guru Ravidas temple, which is located in the South Delhi. So the center has agreed that regarding the protest and to offer and to push down that protest, the center has agreed to allow the same site to the devotee to construct the new temple. So regarding the Guru Ravidas, he was the poet and the saint of the Bhakti movement and the Ramananda. So he was believed to be the disciple. Disciple means the follower of the Bhakti saint poet Ramananda and Bhakti saint poet Kabir. So that is all about the Guru Ravidas being in news. Then third is the Vishwa Shanti Stupa. So there is a 15th golden jubilee of the Vishwa Shanti Stupa in Rajgir. Golden jubilee means 50th anniversary of the Vishwa Shanti Stupa in Rajgir. There are all together nine Shanti Stupa in India, and in which the Vishwa Shanti Stupa is constructed at the Ratnagiri Hill, that is the world highest peace pagoda. So pagoda means the Hindu or the Buddhist temple. So this is all about the Vishwa Shanti Stupa. Then the fifth news is related to the Kartarpur Sahib Corridor Agreement, which is like the yellow journalism in today's newspaper. Kartarpur Sahib Corridor Agreement has been signed between India and Pakistan. So it is called the Road to Peace and will connect the Gurudwara Darbar Sahib in Pakistan, Kartarpur, with the Dera Baba Nayak Srin in India, Gurdaspur district. So its importance is that the Indian people can travel from India to Pakistan in order to pay their homage to in such a devotee place, and for that the Indian citizen will need a passport and a valid passport, and the OC and the person of Indian origin, like the person who is born in or who is of Indian origin, by like his father or the mother is of India are Indian, and but they are born in like in foreign, but they are related to India, so they will need a overseas citizen of India overseas OCI's card in order to travel to the Kartarpur Gurudwara Darbar Sahib. So this is all about the how the road of peace will be connecting the two country, that is Gurdaspur in India and the Kartarpur in Pakistan. And regarding the Kartarpur, that it was the Kartarpur had Guru Nanak assembled a Sikh community and there and lived for 18 years until his death in 1539. So it is believed to be very religious and devotee place for the Sikh peoples. And then the Paramhansa Yogananda. So finance minister has releases a memorial of an event that is the commemorative coin on Paramhansa Yogananda to mark his 125th birth anniversary. So he is basically an Indian monk that introduces the teaching of the Kriya Yoga, and the Kriya Yoga is generally a study or like the yoga of the infinite thoughts that mingles together in order to drive you to the certain action or the right, that is the Kriya. So it mentally direct the Kriya Yoga does that, it may collect all the energy from your body to accommodate at one single place and in order to perform a certain action or the right. So 1/2 minute of revolution of energy around the sensitive spinal cord of man effect subtle progress in its evolution. The 1/2 minute of Kriya equals 1 year of natural spiritual unfoldment. So this is related to the Paramhansa Yogananda. Then the other news is the Tipu Sultan. So the Tipu Sultan is in the news because the Karnataka chief minister again here dropped the hint that the Tipu Sultan, the syllabus of the Tipu Sultan, syllabus of the chapter that is being related to the Tipu Sultan, it need to be dropped out from the state syllabus textbook and the issue need to be reviewed. So the controversy behind the Tipu Sultan syllabus being that is should be removed from the state syllabus textbooks because the Tipu Sultan and his father Hyder Ali Khan used to invade the area around the Mysore and also forced the Hindus to convert to the Islam. So also forced to convert to the Islam. So they are deciding that the Tipu Sultan chapter should be removed or should be dropped from the state syllabus. Keeping aside the fact that he was one of the most courageous ruler that had given the British the hard time. So the conclusion that you can put that it is very improper to judge a figure of past, that here it is written, that is it is very improper to judge the figure of the past by the canon of the present. History should be used to teach the people about the tolerance and the brotherhood rather than dividing based on the communal rights. So this is one of the like best line about the history, that history should be taken in order to teach the people about the brotherhood and the well-known feeling about teacher, not as an excuse or try to find any evidences that will exaggerate the division that is being between the communities further. So this is related to Tipu Sultan. Other news is the Veer Savarkar. So the Veer Savarkar, as we all know, that he played a very important role in the freedom struggle. And Veer Savarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar. So the recently the Home Minister Amit Shah has said that the 1857 revolt that has been viewed in the real context is only because of the Vinayak Damodar Savarkar. Otherwise, it will be viewed through the British lenses. So the Veer Savarkar also organizes the youth organization known as Mitra Mela, and he was also against the foreign good and propagated the idea of Swadeshi. He was the one who has burned all the foreign goods in the bonfire on the Shahra, and he founded the two nation theory book in Hindutva, calling Hindu and Muslim two separate nation. And Hindu Mahasabha is also being passed by the V.D. Savarkar, and has a resolution. And Port Blair Airport, which is located in the Andaman and Nicobar, has been renamed after his name. That is Veer Savarkar International Airport. Other news is the Azad Hind government, which we all know it is being founded by Netaji Subhashan in Singapore in 1943. And it is in the news because 76th anniversary of the formation of Azad Hind Force is being celebrated. So it has been formed because the Subhashan Bose believed that the violence is the only way in order to free India from the British rule. So they had organized the armed struggle to be fought against the British during the Second World War, but unfortunately they are not successful, and they are finally being suppressed. So this is related how where the formation of the Azad Hind Force has been happened, that is in the Singapore by the Subhash Chandra Bose, and the Captain Lakshmi headed the women organization, Shreya Iyer headed the publicity and propaganda wings, and Ras Bihari Bose was designated as the supreme advisor. So then next news is Tanaji Malusade. So Tanaji Malusade, he is in the news because a Bollywood movie is being made on Subedar Tanaji Malusade. He is the military leader of the Chhatrapati Shivaji, and he was one of the main player in the Battle of Singhagad, and in which he got in which he was he died he fight and died bravely, and in order to remark his courageous fight in that battle, the Fort Gondwana has been named after him by the Shivaji in order to honor Tanaji. That is Singhagada Fort. Fort Gondwana has been renamed as the Singhagada Lion Fort by Shivaji in order to honor Tanaji. So this Tanaji is in the news because the Bollywood movie is being made on the Tanaji. Then other news is related to Satnami Rebellion. So Satnami Rebellion are the militant sects of the Hindu worshippers. So their name has the it was founded by the saint named the Bhirwan. So they are considered to be the marginalized group of the Hindu worshipper. So they are basically the marginalized groups. So they always being agitated by the privileges or the discrimination that privileges that is given to the higher section, and the discrimination that they always faced. So they organizes the rebellion organizes the rebellion against the Mughal Empire and the rebellion was ultimately crushed by the Aurangzeb because he had the greater number of troops with artillery, and the conclusion from the Satnami revolt you can get is that the group of the marginalized people found the systematic cooperation in the society, established a new community and defended it. That a group of marginalized people that is being always marginalized, not given any voice, but their agitation can prove to be very very powerful and can also very powerful, and that can ultimately bring the chaos in any systematic society. So the marginalized people should be treated and their interests should be kept in view. So that is all for today, and hope you like the video, and we'll continue with the further topics that is given in the insights. And as you can see, the most of the topics had been taken from the source The Hindu. So basically it is the Hindu analysis. So keep watching if you like, and keep subscribe to the channel if you like the video, and we'll meet soon again. Thank you.